Check, check, check. I got my little brother DJ Squizzy Taylor coming in. DJ Ktone 2020, we finna go up right now. You know this gonna be a good one. I got my brother DJ Ktone in here. I mean, my brother DJ Squizzy Taylor. I'm Ktone. I got Squizzy Taylor with me today, though. I got Squizzy Taylor with me today. Share the live real quick. Share the live real quick. Share the live real quick. Let's go.
I need 10 freaky girls. 10 freaky girls. Don't need them faithful. I need 10 freaky girls. 10 freaky girls. Who gon' pop it on the table? I need 10 freaky girls. 10 freaky girls. Is you fucking or not? I need 10 freaky girls. 10 freaky girls. Ain't no cuffing these stars.
Squizzy Taylor coming in right now. Hold on. If you're on here with me right now, I need you to be on here with me. I need you to share the live. I need you to share the live real quick. Hey. DJ Squizzy Taylor in the building. What's happening? Hold on. Let me let this hook ride, Squizzy. Let me let this hook ride real quick.
I need 10 freaky girls.
Uh-huh.
10 freaky girls.
Uh-huh.
Don't need them faithful. I need 10 freaky girls.
Okay.
10 freaky girls. Who gon' pop it on the table? I need 10 freaky girls.
How many?
10 freaky girls.
That's a lot.
I need 10 freaky girls.
Okay.
10 freaky girls.
Yeah, hold up.
Wait a minute.
Squizzy Taylor in the building. What's happening?
What's happening? Can you hear me?
I got my little brother Squizzy
in the
building.
You hear me?
Yeah. What's happening, Squizzy?
What's going on, man? How you doing? How you living, baby?
Man, come on, man. You know I'm living, man. You know I'm still living.
On everything.
You know what I'm saying? So look, I told myself, I'm gonna start getting my brothers, man. I'm gonna start giving my DJs they flowers, man. While I can smell them, man. I'm taking your advice right now, man.
Absolutely, bro. That's so important. That we celebrate life while we here, while we can tell each other that we great. You know what I mean?
Yeah, on everything I love. Real quick, first thing, man, all the people that's on here, man, I appreciate y'all getting on. What we do need y'all to do, share the live. Share this with everybody in your on your contacts right now, man. DJ Ktone, Squizzy Taylor, 20 and 20.
Yeah,
we going in. Real quick.
What up?
You already know. But this is how we do it, man. Ktone 2020. We ask 20 questions in 20 minutes, but you know, we probably got more questions than that.
Ask everything, baby. I'm an open book today.
We're gonna run through it.
Act like you don't even know me today. You know what I mean?
Okay, but ain't none of that. Oh, I can't answer that. Oh, I don't know. Okay.
I'm with it.
It got to be an answer.
Just don't go too crazy, but I got you.
Don't go too crazy. I ain't gonna crazy. You know we're gonna have fun. First thing though, man, a lot of people want to know, a lot of people always ask me this.
Okay.
What's the meaning behind your name, man? How did you get your name?
It's two reasons. Well, first, the Squizzy movement happened. That was a Priest, Trev, AP. I was in college still when they, you know what I'm saying? Trev just called me like, bro, we switching up. Not switching up, but we about to start. Because, you know, with G5, it's G5 everything, you know what I'm saying? And we needed something that everybody could rep. Everybody could feel like they could be a part of.
Right.
You know? So we started the Squizzy. And then I was in college, and that's when I decided I wanted to DJ, you know what I'm saying? So I needed a DJ name.
Okay.
And I was going to be DJ Wave, you know what I'm saying? Something like
yeah.
way before, you know what I mean? And then Cook, everybody was like, nah, that ain't it, you know what I'm saying? So it came while I was already doing my first party, and they asked me, you know, what's your DJ name?
Yeah.
So just super quick on some random shit, I Googled Squizzy. You know what I'm saying? First thing that popped up was this mob boss.
Okay.
Super gangster, you know what I'm saying? And his name was Squizzy Taylor. And at the time, like, Rick Ross was popping. That's when ASAP, Rocky, and them was popping.
Yeah.
I'm like, and I'm in Oklahoma, so I'm like, nigga, this would be a way that I could, you know what I'm saying, use my platform to help the brand that we trying to build. You know what I'm saying? So.
Definitely.
Turned into Squizzy Taylor, and I just ran with it ever since.
That's dope. So a lot of people, I mean, we brought it up. You're talking about, you might as well just tell them. I mean, I know a lot of people really don't know, man. Tell them what Squizzy really means.
It means exquisite, like an exquisite lifestyle, you know what I'm saying?
A
dope lifestyle, a dope, you know, everything, you know what I mean? Not just music, not just DJing, or it can mean, you know what I'm saying? You can use it anywhere in life.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
So give us the history behind G5 and the Box Boys, man. Give us some history.
What you mean? Like how it came together?
How it came together? Because I know all y'all went to school together, but how the actual Box Boys and G5 come together musically? Back then.
Well, back then, I mean, it started. Well, I would say we kind of all knew each other, you know what I'm saying, from basketball, from sports, you know what I'm saying? Everybody went to different schools, but, you know, me and Trev go back to third grade. Me and, you know what I'm saying, Trev knew other people, you know what I'm saying, I knew other people. So then by the time everybody started making music and by the time you found us, you know what I'm saying, it was, yeah, everything was coming together, you know what I'm saying? It's lovely, and then we wanted to be, like, you know what I'm saying, that next elite, you know what I'm saying? That next group of talented people and put the city together. But we always wanted to be solo artists. Like, we wanted to do our own thing, but have a, you know what I'm saying, not be classified as a group, but like a clique of just, and everybody be dope, right, you know what I'm saying? So, and we, the Box Boys, just Colorado, so, you know what I'm saying, we went with the Box, and nigga, everybody who was a part of that still doing it, still grinding, still getting it, you know what I mean?
So name the original members of the Box Boys.
Don't put me on the spot like that, bro. I don't want to be
original members, man.
Shit. Okay. Trev, AP, Miracle, G6, L Keys, Priest, Hakeem, BH. Fuck, I don't want to leave nobody out, man. Shit. I hope, who am I forgetting? Am I forgetting somebody?
That sounds about right.
Yeah, that sounded about right. And I'm sure there's more, though. But, yeah, that was the big dogs.
And it's crazy because everybody's still making heat. Like,
yeah,
he's got something that just dropped. Miracle just sent me something yesterday. He trying to...
Yeah, he sent me something, too. Yeah.
BH got a super banger.
Yeah.
That's crazy, man. Box Boys.
Yeah.
100 Rack 6. 100 Rack 6 changes. Well, G6, 100 Rack 6.
Yeah.
Got one of the hottest songs in the city. While we're talking about it real quick, hottest song in the city.
The hottest song in the city right now?
To you,
The hottest song in the city, it got to be released, don't it?
Yeah,
got to
be released.
Oh, see, I wasn't ready for all this, man. The hottest song in the city, I'm gonna go with. Can I look at my phone? Can I cheat? Can I get two?
Give me two.
Kayla Ray featuring Nay Renee, Too Late.
Okay.
And I'm gonna go with AP, Larry Kennedy.
Okay, I like those two. So let's go back to the DJ, man. So when you got your name and you said you was in college, what moment did you know, though, you wanted to be a DJ? Because remember, you was Lil Bill at the parties, dancing.
Yeah, facts.
You know what I'm saying? What moment did you know you actually wanted to
Do that? The DJ? Well, shout out. I got an OG that was at my school, Langston University. His name was DJ Kilo. You know what I'm saying? That was when I went to college. He did all the parties. He did everything. He was dope. Super dope. Still super dope. You know what I'm saying? Then he ended up graduating, and, you know what I'm saying, there became a gap where we didn't have no school DJs. You know what I'm saying? Everybody was trying, but nobody was really dope like that. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? So we would go to parties, and I would just tell Cook, and I got some other homies from back at school, like, bro, I could do this. You know what I'm saying? I know I could do this. You know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying? I always be the one that had the music growing up. You know what I'm saying? I had the playlist or whatever. Or made the CDs with the mixes on there and all that.
Yeah.
So I'm sure I could do this. And then, you know, Cook and everybody else, like, man, fuck it. Do it. Like, let's go. You know what I'm saying? I just had the right people around me that believe, like, nigga, if you say you can do something, let's do it. Fuck it. You know what I'm saying?
So, for sure.
I had a computer, so I started off virtual DJ. You know what I'm saying? Computer, but I would always save the money. Get something else.
Yeah.
And, you know what I'm saying? Build from there.
That's dope. So do you remember your actual first party you did?
Yep.
And how it felt?
Hell yeah. It was cracking.
Tell me about it.
It lit. It was cracking. I did it was the Welcome Back to School for the freshmen. Welcome back to college. Welcome back to school party for the freshmen. Shout out my man Puck. He from L.A. He put me on. He was the student activities coordinator.
Yeah.
I was already cool with him just from, you know, being around this shit. So he like, fuck it, I'll give you a chance, bro. Come on. It was cracking. Yeah.
That's hard.
All right.
I want to talk a little bit about, so you made a post recently. What was that? Yesterday, maybe? About the XXL list. Yeah. And how the artist wasn't mad about that list.
Yeah.
But they was mad about the list in Colorado.
The local, yeah.
What's your take on all these lists being made and who's making them? And like, what you feel about it?
I feel it's all opinion. So everybody has the right to, you know what I'm saying, make their list or think how they want to think about, you know, what they like. I can make a list. No list makes it right. You know what I'm saying? No list makes it what it is, but it's everybody's opinion. I made that post just because we get so tied up in wanting our peers and the people we grew up with to love us so much, you know what I'm saying? Instead of thinking about the big goal. And that's to be worldwide, like, you know what I'm saying? We should be mad that we're not on the Forbes list. You know what I'm saying? If you're an artist, you are upcoming, you should be mad you're not on XXL because you should think your shit just as hard as everybody else around the world. You know what I'm saying? Hard where you from. Like, you know what I'm saying? It's bigger than that, and we just got to start thinking outside the box. You feel what I'm saying? And like, it's dope to be, me and Trev had this conversation where it was like, nigga, we was talking and he was like, bro, I've been number one on that list for the last 6 years. You know what I'm saying? Every list that ever came out of Denver, I was number one. Right. But I was broke. You feel what I'm saying? Like, right. I get all the girls and I was popping in the city, but I had no money. Right. And he's like, crazy, I'm finally getting shit going like how it need to be going. And I'm number seven, you know what I'm saying?
Right.
Stop focusing on just pleasing Denver and start, you know what I'm saying, trying to please the world. Like, just made his mindset bigger. You know what I'm saying? So,
you know,
I'm at with it.
You know what I'm gonna ask you next?
What's up?
Give me your top 10 list, man.
Come on, man. Why are we doing this?
All right, but this is what I was gonna say. It don't have to be them. I'm talking about just artists. I need your top 10 artists.
Ever or just like right now?
Just period.
Right. I mean, you gotta tell me ever.
Give me right now. Top 10 right now.
Fuck it. Let me put my homies on there. Trevor Rich, okay. AP, 2. Nay Renee.
Okay.
3. I'm gonna do everywhere. Lil Baby.
Okay.
Drake, Jizzy Drake. Yeah. Jizzy Drake 5. Lil Wayne.
Jay-Z.
You know that. Jay-Z 7. Can I put some all time greats on there that might not be popping right now?
Got 3 more.
Give me DMX.
Okay.
Give me who am I forgetting? I know I'm forgetting somebody good too. Give me Tupac.
Okay.
And give me J. Cole.
Who?
J. Cole.
Okay. Okay, I'll take that. Top 10 DJs.
Ever?
Give them to me.
DJ Ktone.
Okay.
DJ KDJ Above. Top Shelf.
Okay.
DJ Clue.
Okay.
Just Blaze.
5.
Jazzy Jeff.
Okay.
Drama for sure.
Okay. Who we got?
DJ Hollywood Cook.
Okay.
DJ Kilo.
Okay.
The OG, DJ X-Cal from Oklahoma. Oh, and my dog Wayne in this thing. DJ Wayne in this thing, too, yeah.
Wayne in this thing, for sure.
And my man Bar 1, too. Yeah, he up there. All
right, that's about 12, but we good.
Yeah.
Yeezy.
Oh, Kid Capri. Somebody commented Kid Capri. My fault. I forgot about the legend.
That's the thing about lists, too, man. It's never like...
Yeah, it's hard, bro. It's hard. You always gonna miss somebody.
So, Yeezys or Jordans?
Jordans.
Chucks or G-Nikes?
Chucks.
Chucks over
G-Nikes. I got to.
Look, we're going to take it to IG. You got a couple IG questions. I couldn't get them all, but I got a couple for you. This one, shout out to Marjane. She said, is there a person, brand, or artist that inspired? This is a two-part question. Is there a person, brand, or artist that inspires your fashion choices? That's the first question.
Yeah, Pharrell, Fabulous, Pharrell for sure.
Okay.
I always look to Pharrell for what's hot. I definitely say Pharrell. Because he made, and I talked to somebody about the other day, he made, to me, he made like colors cool.
Yeah.
Like, You know what I'm saying? Like, yeah. Basically what I got on, what you got on, he make that cool. You know what I'm saying? Like, you ain't gotta be in black and white. You ain't gotta look hood to be respected. You know what I mean? So,
sure.
I say between him and Fabulous that I could think of off the top of my head.
Okay. Yeah. Second part question. Listen.
Okay.
This ain't mine.
All right, come on.
Does Ktone and the guests really have a fair shot of winning the best shoes on DOS if in your mind you already won? Do you honestly believe you win every Sunday?
Absolutely. I don't think it's been close.
It ain't been close.
It ain't. I mean, maybe week one.
You really didn't win last week, though.
I mean, I'm not the one picking. I'm just reading off.
One person say one. Say something.
That's 1-0. Who won?
You didn't say
if I score one bucket and you score zero, who wins? The person scored one bucket.
Okay. Yeah. Next question. KOTD.
KOTD. What's that?
What's your kicks of the day right now?
Oh.
You pick them off?
No, wait. Don't move. Oh.
No, I ain't no. What you got on, Squizzy?
I ain't got no shoes on. I'll show you what I got. I got some G-Nikes on today. The pink G-Nikes to match it. Yeah, I switched. I'm at the crib, so I got the Givenchy slides on. You know what I'm saying? But, yeah, I got G-Nikes on today. Yeah. And as you see, let me turn it this way. Yeah. I forgot the artist's name, but, yeah. I got some G-Nikes on.
You might have
beat
me today.
Of course I did. What you got on?
If we battle today, mine's simple, too. Simple.
Oh, them was hard though. Them Sicconis, I seen them.
Colors, man.
Yeah, them was hard. Yeah, no, I see you. But you know who won? But I see you.
We're gonna see Sunday. Don't be trying to go out Sunday trying to get some new order something.
Nah.
Just pick something from that rack up there, man.
I'm chilling. Shout out everybody. Show them about my hair. You see it? Yeah. You know what I'm saying? I'm in the comments.
That baby hair. Yeah, I like it.
Yeah. Cameron, I love Cameron. The way Cameron just is very important. I see that comment.
Yeah, for sure. So, man, let's talk about your endeavors, man. Besides DJing, what does Squizzy do? Any other businesses, any investments? What else does Squizzy do besides DJing?
Well, first and foremost, I'd say I'm a promoter. You know what I'm saying? I don't really get booked no more, so I would say I'm a promoter with my brother.
Definitely.
We throw parties, we throw events, we throw stuff like that. We got, you know, the whole company with that. But outside of that, I think, I don't know if I have the right title yet, but I would say I'm an A&R. You know what I'm saying? I put together a lot of projects. I help with a lot of projects. I help with a lot of artists and, you know what I'm saying, give opinions and make sure everything's sounding right. I got a fashion line. Celebrate Life, the clothing line. You know what I'm saying? I do that.
Okay.
I hope I ain't forgetting. Am I forgetting something? Yeah, I'm an investor too in a couple of little businesses on the low.
So that's what I was gonna say. My next thing was gonna say, you know, you've been a DJ, promoter, A&R.
Yeah.
I would call you an influencer for sure.
Yeah.
You even bought into a club. A lot of people don't know this.
Yeah, I know. I could talk about that now.
Okay. Thank you. That was my question. How did you make that happen, man? And for the people that don't, first of all, for the people that don't know, just tell them what club it was that, you know, that you were part owner of. How did you make it happen? And would you do it again?
So I was an owner. I would say I was a silent owner of Dorchester.
Yeah.
You know, during that run. How did I do it? The opportunity kind of fell in my lap with my team, with Hollywood Cook, with Kevin Kane, and the opportunity just presented itself, and it made sense for the time that we did it. Would I ever do it again? You want the honest answer?
Honest answer.
No.
No.
Probably would never do it again.
And why is that?
In that position is. It's a lot of things. I think I ain't gonna say I would never do it again. If I did it again, I'd have to be. I want to be the one making the decisions. You feel me? I would never do it the same way I did it. I say that.
Right.
I have to be the one making the decisions because you know when there's a lot of heads in the room. My bad. Somebody said when you're having a baby. There's a lot of people in the room. you know, every decision you don't agree with, you know what I'm saying? Everything. There's a lot of things you can't control, you know what I'm saying? Even though your money's involved. So, you know, it is what it is. And it worked out, you know what I'm saying?
But at least you got that experience, though, you know.
And the two hats was hard. Like, you know, I just kind of wanted to show up and do what I do, DJ, and put on my party instead of, you know, having to do all the extras.
So, you and Cook, man, y'all took over Denver nightlife, man, crazy past couple years.
Thank you.
Can't really come to Denver, man, and not get the Squizzy Taylor experience. So tell us, what is the Squizzy Taylor experience?
Oh, man.
Speak up.
It's a celebration.
Yeah.
It's a celebration of life, man. We gonna have fun. I would say that we gonna take it on a journey. Like we gonna have fun. We gonna sing together. We gonna dance. We gonna get drunk. We gonna, you know what I'm saying, smoke if you smoke.
Yeah.
I'll make sure you gonna find you something. Hopefully it's your wife, if it's just your wife for the night, or your husband.
Yeah.
All that's gonna happen in the night. You feel what I'm saying? You gonna have it's gonna be a time that you could look back on and remember, like, yeah, I remember that night. You're going to have some memories. When you go to your Instagram next year or whatever, yeah, it's going to be a memory. He was around, you know what I'm saying? So, and it's a celebration. Like, you're going to remember the times you have with your friends. That's what I try to do more than anything. Like, as fucked up as the world is now, it's been fucked up, you know what I'm saying? So,
definitely.
I want to, for a couple hours, for 2, 3, 4 hours, yeah, all that go out the window and you just having fun with the people you're around, like, you know what I'm saying? The people you love, you know what I mean? You gonna hug somebody if you come to my party. All that's gonna happen. You go cheers to somebody, everything.
On everything. What was your, you did a lot of clubs, man, like myself, man. What was your ultimate favorite club you've done by far?
Oh, shit.
Best run, most memorable run you've had.
See, that's two different questions though, because there's an answer where I can say,
well, answer both. What's your favorite club you've done? What's your best club you've done? And what's your best run? Your most favorite run?
Well, my best run for sure would probably be Epinay. Okay. That was the longest run. I think that was the longest run. Epinay was the longest run.
Yeah.
I think the most legendary nights that we had was in Epinay. You know what I'm saying? That was the Super Bowl year. We won the Super Bowl. So that year, with all the Broncos coming, Nuggets coming, we had Future come, Young Thug came, Esco, like, and Future was at the top of his game. You know what I'm saying? So a lot of people, I know I'm forgetting hella people, but I would say that was
crazy.
Yeah, that changed. That put me on when the Broncos, I always tell everybody, the year the Broncos won the Super Bowl made me quote unquote Squizzy Taylor.
Yeah.
You feel me? And just the opportunities that I had that year. But my favorite club to DJ in would be a tie between Dorchester, just because I never got to DJ in something that nice and that big until that point, or Cold Crush, just because the energy that, you know, was brought to Cold Crush, it was small, but you couldn't miss in Cold Crush. That's probably the only club I've ever done where it's like you can't miss. You can't play
a I think if a DJ missed a Cold Crush, it was something wrong with them.
Yeah, it was over. It was over. You like you had and just all the DJs that was there with you, Moose, to everybody, it was like you had to come with your shit. Like, you know what I'm saying? And I feel like I got a lot of respect because of Cold Crush. Like y'all started, the OGs was like, okay, I see you, young nigga. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, you know what I'm saying? So I would say that definitely. The energy in Cold Crush is unmatched. You know what I'm saying? So,
what do you prefer, radio or club? DJ.
Club.
Club.
Yeah.
But tell us how you got in radio, man. Because you know it's hard to get in radio for a DJ, especially where we at, man. Tell us how you got into the radio and experience so far.
Oh, so I got in the radio. Shout out Berm Gotti. Berm really plugged me though.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Berm hit me up earlier before it was the opportunity presented himself, and he told me, like, bro, get your shit together. Okay. Tighten up. I'm going to have an opportunity for you soon. Like, you know what I'm saying? Clean your shit up. Like, get right.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? And then the opportunity presented himself. I'll never forget it. And he hit me, like, bro, hurry up. Apply for this right now. send me a mix. I need it by tomorrow type shit. You know what I'm saying? And I was geeked. You know what I'm saying? I sent the coldest mix. Or to me, it was the coldest mix at the time. Like, you know, and, you know, after that, it was history. I met Victor Starr, you know what I'm saying? And we linked like that, you know what I'm saying? We clicked. He was East Coast dude, you know, my family from the East Coast, so we got one another, you know what I mean? And we clicked immediately, and then I started doing the mix show for, I think, like 2 years, maybe 3 years, doing that. Yeah. And then I was blessed with the opportunity to work with Rosa on her show, the Middays. And then we created the 12 o'clock boombox, which we, you know what I'm saying? At first, I was just doing it on Fridays, which was dope, you know what I'm saying? And then it was received hella well, so then we got to, you know, expand to every day of the week.
Man, and shout out to 175, man, for picking up the hottest young DJ in the city, man. I appreciate that for sure.
Hell yeah. He told me love, too.
Yeah, for sure. Mm-hmm. How you manage to stay afloat, man, and stay going through this pandemic? And what have you learned so far during this pandemic?
I stay afloat, nigga, because I'm a hustler, bro. Like, right. You got the hustler, like. If you only got one hustle, you ain't no hustler. You know what I'm saying? Like, you gotta have multiple hustles. You gotta, nigga, I done been broke before. You know what I'm saying? I done had nothing before. And when I thought I had something, it's been taken away. Pledging helped me a lot. You feel what I'm saying? Like, really having nothing. You know what I'm saying? Break you all the way down. Or I'll say, joining a fraternity, I ain't gonna go into all that. But breaking you all the way down and, you know what I'm saying, showing you how to survive, like, nigga, ain't nothing like that college struggle, nigga. Like, you know what I'm saying? Especially not being home, going to that college. I couldn't just call my mama and go home and get some food. Like, you got to figure it out. Pledging, you know what I'm saying? Just, it built a different type of hustle in me. Yes. And the no excuses, like, nigga, you got to figure it out. You got to get it. You know what I'm saying? So
that college life be real, man.
Yeah, facts.
Being out of state at college will make or break somebody and make them for the better for life. I'm telling you.
I wish more people did it. I wish more people did it, bro. I really feel like, not to take away from the education I got, but just as a man, as a human, leaving the nest and going somewhere taught me more about myself than anything has. You feel what I'm saying? So, so I would say that, bro. Just knowing how to not have, you know what I'm saying? Knowing how to create new situations, knowing how to just survive.
Definitely.
You know what I'm saying? I learned. And what has COVID taught me? I think more from what I've learned is, or more than what I've learned is, it gave me a chance to sit down and I ain't going to say not live in the moment, but appreciate things that I've done.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? But at the same time, It put a stop to that shit for I could see what's the things I want to do. You know what I'm saying? What's next? What other goals do I want to reach? Or what else am I good at? What else could I be good at? You know what I'm saying? It gave me a time to sit down and think about that. Because when we going, nigga, we just going. You ain't thinking. You just moving. You feel what I'm saying? COVID really let me sit down and be like, okay, nigga, this is cool, but you going to stay at this level forever? Or you want this and this and this, you know what I'm saying? So I look at it like a blessing, you know what I'm saying? It sucks for sure, you know what I'm saying? But you can't look at everything like for the money, you know what I'm saying? You got to look bigger than that, and that's what I've been trying to look at.
What's your take on all the protests, everything that's been going on with Breonna Taylor, Elijah McClain, George Floyd? What's your take on the actual protests? And we ask this question to all our people on Sundays, but do you feel like there's change happening, and there will be change as well?
That's a great question. Well, with the protests, it's crazy because I made a controversial post when it first happened, and I was on some, why we keep we need to do something more than protest, because we keep protesting and shit ain't changing. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
But this time, I felt like something, I don't know, I'm not going to lie and say shit's changed yet, you know what I'm saying? People, shit's still going on, it's still fucked up.
Right.
But I do think that we had some effect this time. You know what I'm saying? I realized I was wrong. Like, okay, I see if we protest and do it the right way, and you know what I'm saying? We got to fuck some shit up a little bit. You know what I'm saying? Cause everything it's about money at the end of the day. And once you, that's how you get to somebody's mind is through money. You know what I'm saying? Once you start fucking up their money, they start listening. You feel what I'm saying? So I think we definitely have had some effect, but I feel like the job is done or shit changed. Nah, I can't say that.
Yeah.
It's still fucked up, but you know.
What we
having a conversation. That's good. Some of them is listening.
Yeah.
Some don't give a fuck, but some of them's listening. You know what I mean?
Definitely having a conversation.
Yeah.
What books you reading right now?
Damn, I don't want to. Can I go get it? You want me to go get it? It'll be like 5 seconds.
Go get it. Yeah. DJ Squizzy Taylor. Appreciate everybody who's on here. If you're still on here, share the live for me. Share the live one time.
See, you could have had me ready. So look, I'm reading the Unapologetic Guide to Black Mental Health.
Okay.
I was supposed to already read it, but I didn't get going.
Okay.
It's by Rita Walker.
I'm gonna have to get that one.
Yeah, thanks. I'll give you mine.
For sure.
But I know somebody on here like, man, you supposed to been read that because I bought it like a month ago, but I ain't got around to getting into it though. All right,
for sure. Yeah. We'll take another IG question. This real life questions. These ain't mine. This is a real question. She on here too. Shout out Kayla Ray. She has some questions for you.
What she say? Something crazy?
She got four questions for you. She said,
four?
Is Kayla Ray your favorite artist?
Yes. Ever.
Okay. She said, do you love playing Kayla Ray's music?
I do. She has a good way of, the way she flows is going to make you dance. I think because she could dance, she make music where You could bounce to it. You know what I'm saying? You could ride to it. You know what I mean? Yeah. So I absolutely enjoy playing the music.
Is Kayla Ray your favorite artist to DJ for on stage?
Ooh. Ooh, god damn, you gonna give me some trouble. She asked that?
Yes, this is her question. I'm looking at it right now.
Damn, is the other homies on here? they all my favorite. Yeah, yes, she is.
She said, are you gonna be her friend forever?
Of course. She ain't got no choice. She can't get rid of me.
Shout out Kayla Ray, man. Kayla Ray got one of the dopest albums out right now, for sure.
My sister forever. I love her.
On a more serious note, man, what do you feel is your contribution, man, to the Colorado music culture?
My contribution?
What's your contribution?
So far or what I want it to be?
No, so far. So far.
I definitely feel so political. I would say I brought some energy. That's a good question. I can answer that so many type of cocky ways, but I'm trying to think of.
Hey man,
humble.
Take your advice and you weren't your post the other day.
That ain't me. I would say just a good time. You know what I'm saying? A good time, a positive energy. You know what I'm saying? A light. Somebody who. I feel like a lot of people never seen me in a bad mood. So right. If you're around me, you're going to be in a good mood. You feel what I'm saying? Yeah, so
definitely.
a positive light and example of somebody that, I like to say I made it. You feel what I'm saying?
Yeah,
and
but
like somebody who made it, somebody you could look up to, somebody who, you know what I'm saying? Come from where you come from, but took a different route or somebody. Went to college, somebody who played, somebody who got a degree, somebody that done traveled the world, somebody that, you know what I'm saying, did everything, like, tried to be a rapper, dancer, basketball player, done all that shit, you know what I'm saying? Somebody who know the hoodest niggas, but somebody who know the richest motherfuckers, you know what I'm saying? Like, just an example of somebody who, you know what I'm saying, maneuvering through it all and doing it with a smile on his face.
So we're saying that, what do you want your legacy to be when it's all said and done?
I want a statue. I always told my mama and I tell the homies all the time, I always wanted to be the mayor, but I don't want to be the man no more.
No.
I don't want to be the man.
All right.
I don't want to be the man no more. So I want to my legacy to just, hopefully I inspire some people that you could do it and that you could love let me answer it this way. I think I want to inspire people to know that you could love music and not have to be a rapper and be successful.
Definitely.
You know what I'm saying? And you could, yeah. Like, there's so many ways you can get money in music and not have to be the center of attention. You feel what I'm saying? Not have to be the rapper.
That's and, real. Yeah. People really need to take that.
You could love me. There's so many things you could do.
So many other things.
Yeah.
That's for another day. Shout out to Christian B, man. He actually had one of my questions, man, but we'll credit him for it. Christian B, he said, how was it performing in Africa, man? Tell us about that.
Oh, man, it was the best thing I've ever done in my life by far.
A lot of people haven't made it there, man. I ain't been in Africa, for sure.
Anybody who asks me about Africa, the first thing I say is go. Go see it for yourself. Go see your people. Go see the history. Go feel the air. Go feel the water. It's going to make you just move different, make me feel different. Like, you know what I'm saying? My whole life changed doing that. Even if I didn't DJ, my whole life changed by going to Africa.
I mean, give us a little bit of the experience real quick.
Man, it was lovely, bro. I went to Nigeria first and foremost. I was with one of the princes of Nigeria. You know what I'm saying? Shout out my man Prince. His name is Prince too. You know what I'm saying? So my experience was a little different because I was with a prince. You know what I'm saying? I had two bodyguards with me the entire time with choppers. I had I forgot what the truck is called that rides in front of you. The police car that rides in front of you.
The parade.
Yeah.
Whatever it's called.
One of those, you know what I'm saying? Right. Everywhere we went, it was so much love. Everybody's so welcoming. It's nothing like what they teach us.
Right.
And it's beautiful, bro. It's beautiful. It's developed. It looks just like any other city. You know what I'm saying? It's big buildings. Nigeria's like damn near on the water, so it's like going to Miami. You know what I'm saying? The women are beautiful as fuck. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? Every shade, they just beautiful. They nice. They sweet. It's so much culture. The food is amazing.
Yeah.
Everything there, bro. You could tell, nigga, we supposed to be there, and everything you need in life is in the ground in Africa. You know what I'm saying? And you could feel that, and it's the truth.
I remember you saying when you came back, you said, man, Tone, everything we learned about Africa was taught was a lie.
Absolutely. 100%. Everything, bro.
Yeah.
And I ain't going to fake the funk. And the one thing that, you know, there is no middle class.
Yeah.
But I've been to the Middle East. I've been to South America. I've been all that. There's nowhere, I say besides Europe, but nowhere else is there really a middle class. It's either you have it or you might not have no shoes on. You feel what I'm saying? Like you might not have nothing. You know what I'm saying? Or you have it all. You feel what I'm saying? But they don't care about money the way we care about money. You feel what I'm saying? They way more about love and camaraderie and family and all that. You feel what I'm saying? Like, money's not like America. Money's up here. Everything else is down here. It's not like that nowhere else. You know what I'm saying? Especially not Africa.
Yeah.
But no.
That's dope, man. What? So, is Africa your favorite country you've been to so far? Or what's your favorite country you've actually been to?
Africa.
Africa. For sure.
With a close second coming in with the DR. Dominican Republic is in second.
Close second.
Yeah.
Favorite city to travel to frequently?
Miami.
Miami.
For sure. Ain't nothing like, if I, when I the means, that's where I'm retiring, in Miami. For sure.
Wellen Street.
Africa is a continent. I'm sorry. I guess that wasn't the question. So the answer would be Nigeria. I'm sorry, Mom.
Okay. Yeah. You have to be politically correct.
Yeah, my bad.
Moms, for sure. Wellen Street or Catfish Haven?
Wellen Street.
Cream of wheat or grits?
Grits. What is cream of wheat? I ain't never.
What is cream?
I ain't never had that. I ain't grits though. All
right, grits. Yeah, Culture grits. Street or Notorious?
Let me say the first one.
Culture Street or Notorious?
Notorious.
Actually, no. Take it back.
Okay.
Culture Street or Victory Clothing?
Victory Clothing. Oh, God.
Get to Victory Clothing. Buy some.
Yeah, shout out Iman. I got to go pull up, too. I need to pull up, man.
We pull up tomorrow. I got to pull up, too.
Shout out Culture Street. Shout out Culture Street. Shout out Catfish Haven too. I still love them.
RTD or light rail?
Shit. I've been on the RTD, Mo, but I've been on the light rail recently, so I'm going to go with RTD.
All right. Trev Rich or AP? And don't say you can't
answer. Come on, bro.
Trev Rich or AP? You got to answer.
Neither. Me, Squizzy Taylor.
Last two questions, man. Finish the statements. Squizzy Taylor is?
That motherfucking Nick. It's like, Squizzy Taylor is... help me, cook. Educated, strong, hustling, long hair, fly than a motherfucker, cool ass, ladies man.
Yeah.
Extraordinaire, amazing song selector, the best shoe closet you ever gonna see. Goddamn. Caramel skin, motherfucking legend. You feel me?
Okay, I like it. DJ Ktone is
a motherfucking legend, living legend. The logo, statue, nigga.
Yeah. So look, Swizzy. A lot of people don't know, man. You got your own song. I want to play your song right now, man.
Yeah, play that
stunt. Introduce it though. You got to introduce it.
This is Stunt, DJ Squizzy Taylor featuring Trev Rich. Doobie Newton, okay. Sayari the Kid.
Uh-huh.
Is more on there? No, that's it. Yeah.
That's it. We're gonna get into it.
Stunt. It's called Stunt. You did run this up.
Let's go, Squizzy.
Squizzy Taylor.
Yes. Squizzy got his own song. It's called Stunt. This is my little brother Squizzy Taylor. If you got some questions for him, you can holler at him right now. He in the chat.
Girl, all my niggas really rolling.
Hey.
You could disappear, hocus pocus.
Hey.
Sexy, but I got an ocean open. All these saucy bitches overdose. Money moving like a locomotive. Got it, daddy, so they know the slow. We ain't riding, bitch, we roller coaster.
If you got questions for Squizzy, put them in the chat right now.
Can't do stunt, can't do stunt, can't do stunt. Blue face hunt, can't do stunt, can't do stunt, can't do stunt. Blue face hunt. Girl, all my niggas really rolling, rolling. You could disappear, hocus pocus. Say she what I got.
Make sure you follow him right now. At DJ Squizzy Taylor, let's go.
All these checks are like a bucket list. I eat y'all click, y'all all selfishes. Magnums on me, that's a rubber grip. I wrote my verses with an oven mitt. I'm getting tired of the club and shit. I'm starting five, but I sub a bitch. Put long Trev, I sub your bitch. And I can't do stunt, V12 under. Broke ass niggas already gotta say something. I'm mellow with the hoodie, bring it lightning to the thunder. With some hoes,
2020 with DJ Squizzy Taylor right now.
You ain't no boss, nigga, you are just a runner. We been through the lanes with a double with a bundle. I told him I'm a ball, I ain't never had a fun way. I'm wrestling with you niggas, but just stick a real rumble.
Favorite tequila.
Hey.
All my niggas really rolling, rolling.
Big shout to the R Network.
Say she wet, I got an ocean open. All these sauces, bitches overdose. And we can't do stunt.
R Network, digital online showcase. Me and Squizzy Taylor on Sunday, every Sunday, 8 p.m. DOS, 8 p.m.
I take your wife, let's forget the boom. Go watch your mom catch your extra wound. We be so deep, not your extra room. I hit a bitch in my dressing room. My heart so cold, need some Theraflu. She smart that we like in medical. Hydra got back from the broke house. The nigga broke and even got their own house. Kicking the dough now. I'm adjusting to the weather. I'm in Denver with the stat named Selena. Niggas saying she exposing whoever. Check that hoe and now I know she no better. That between me and her, I don't even give a fuck. One team, one us. Whole team going up. Yeah. And I know that she would it.
Hey.
And I know I'm in a freeze. Diamonds it blue like a cheese. Don't get car reaching for these. Girl, all my niggas really rolling, rolling. You could disappear, hocus pocus. Say she wet, I got an ocean open. All these saucy bitches overdose. Money moving like a locomotive. Got a daddy so they know the slogan. We ain't riding, bitch, we roller coaster. That's a bitch, we out here rope a dope. And we can't do stunt, can't do stunt, can't do stunt. Blue face hot, can't do stunt, can't do stunt, can't do stunt. Blue face hot. Girl, all my niggas really rolling, rolling. You could disappear, hocus pocus. Say she wet, I got an ocean open. All these saucy bitches overdose.
Yeah.
Squizzy Taylor in the building, man. I appreciate you, bro.
Yes, could they? I didn't know if they could hear me while I was.
They heard you.
Oh, okay. answering questions, but I ain't know if they can hear me.
Yeah. They keep asking you all kind of questions. Do you want kids? All that, man.
Yeah, man. I'm trying to have about 10 of them. I'm running out of time, though.
You said that now. I said that, too, when I said I want 10.
I just want a wife first, bro. I just want a family, man. You know what I mean? I don't want a baby mother. That's what I'm waiting on, but I'm getting old. I'm about to just pick somebody.
You about to eat any meeny money more?
Yeah, man. Just give them all one, man. Fuck it.
Well, man, I appreciate you getting on. Look, when I see you Sunday, I'm gonna bring you them white and gold boys right there.
Ooh, yeah, bring them.
I'm gonna bring you the white and gold boys right there.
That's it? I need that and some more. These are all types.
I got you. I'm gonna bring you a couple. I'm gonna bring some different colors, man. I'm gonna bring some different colors to go with all the fits, man, for the City Fridays, man.
For sure. Yeah, need it.
Yeah.
Sure. I appreciate you having me, man. You're a legend. I appreciate this.
You know that?
I want all the other DJs to know I'm the first DJ. You know what I'm saying? That's how I go down. Holla at your boy. I'm the first.
anything you want to promote, man, holla at the people right now before we go.
I want to promote that I'm looking for a secretary. You know what I'm saying? Shout out Tux, who keeps writing that at times. I'm looking for a secretary. I'm looking for some artists as well. You know what I'm saying? I'm looking for some producers. I'm trying to, you didn't even ask me about this, but I'm putting together an album. You know what I'm saying?
Tell us.
Album coming. You know what I'm saying? I'm trying to get on my Khaled, my Ktone type of.
Yeah.
I'm putting an album together, man. I need some producers, bro. I need producers. That's what I want to promote. I need a secretary and some producers.
We're going to get Squizzy a secretary and some producers. If you're a good secretary on here, if you know some producers, you got some producers on deck,
yeah,
send them Squizzy's way, man.
Yeah, outside of that, man, everybody be safe. Wear your mask, but still go outside. Don't just be in the house, man. Get you some sun.
Yeah.
Make sure you drink your water. Drink more water. Make sure you smile. Make sure you thankful for something every day. Before you grab your phone in the morning, do something else. Do something else before you grab your phone. Be thankful. Pray, you know what I'm saying? Think about don't just grab your phone first. You feel what I'm saying? Drink some water. Drink more wine. You should be drinking more wine and less liquor. Drink more wine. Call your mama.
Yeah.
Where your kids at? Shout out, Brother Jeff. Where your kids at? Know where
your kids at.
You know what I mean? Call your parents, man. You know what I'm saying? That's the biggest blessing we have.
Yeah.
Appreciate them while you're here. They got so much knowledge, especially in time like this. Call your friends, check on your people. What else? Shit, man, I can keep going, man. I got stop human trafficking. You know what I'm saying? Talk to your kids. I can't give kid advice. I ain't got kids, but talk to them and be better every day. Make some goals. Write down some goals.
Write it down in
a real piece of paper. Don't put it in your phone. Really write it down and make some goals.
You know what I'm gonna do? I wasn't gonna do it, but I think I might do it. I don't know. I'm gonna send it to you first. I'm gonna send you my daily regimen, man. I'm gonna send you my new daily regimen.
And
tell me if I should post it or not. It might be some good motivation for somebody.
Okay, and eat some vitamins, man. You had me when you put me on that really changed my life, and I thank you for that, bro.
Yeah, for sure.
It helped me, giving me more energy and shit. So
definitely.
Eat vitamins. Go find some vitamins and all that. And I'm going to start doing the vegetables like you told me, too.
Got to do the vegetables, man. And get rid of all them fruit snacks you got. Eat more vegetables.
Yeah. You're right.
Taylor, man, I appreciate you, brother. I'm going to see you Sunday.
You know it's love, brother. For the City Fridays. You did.
For the City Friday, for sure.
20 and 20 is love, brother. I love you.
On everything. Love you, too. One love. Make sure you support Squizzy Taylor. Follow Squizzy Taylor. Support all his endeavors. Digital Online Showcase every Sunday. Me and Squizzy Taylor every Sunday via the R Network, the R page on Facebook. Artists, submit your music. This week we got Jice Johnson and we have Iman Sax coming in this Sunday, 8 p.m. Mountain Standard Time. Tune in to that. If you're an artist and you want your music played, you want your music critiqued, send it in. DigitalOnlineShowcase@gmail.com. DigitalOnlineShowcase@gmail.com. That's what it is. 20 and 20 next week. We got some dope guests. I got a whole bunch of dope guests coming up, man. Just keep it locked. Follow me at DJ Ktone, official DJKTone.com. This is the website. Appreciate y'all.